Welcome to the vlog.
Season 3.
Welcome to the vlog.
Wow, hello. We had a typical Monday. I went to the gym, had coffee with George, and then I came back for work. I did a little bit of time in a cafe, came home, had some more meetings, and I got my new sunglasses. I was super excited.
We're at the end of the workday, and it's time for me to go on my ride. Looking forward to it. We're just going to Deep Coast. That's going to be like 50 for the day. Actually, pretty warm out. I'm still going to wear arm warmers just to see how I feel, and I can always take them off.
We did a pretty easy ride. We just went out to Deep Cove. This was really nice. My dad also stopped in a bike store to pick up his new bike. It was really fun and warm out. I was just very happy, except for the fact that I got a flat, but we got to a bike store in time, and this dog Buddy was so, so sweet. He was just the sweetest little old man. Anyways, the flat was fixed and we were able to go home and have some pizza. Just a very nice day.
I filmed a whole nobody asked video. Happy I did it, but low key, like I just was not feeling like filming. I feel a little bit worked up at the moment. And I wish I didn't, but it's okay. What I'm trying to do to mitigate is just try and chill out for the rest of the night. There's nothing for me to be like truly worked up about. I'm just like, I don't know what's wrong with me. Anyways, today was a really good day though, honestly. I just need to zen out a little bit and get back on track to having a good week. It's about 5 a.m., so heading out on my run. Feeling pretty okay. Allergies are bothering me a little bit, so obviously reacting and then get out the door.
Had a good little speed run. I was pretty sore, and I honestly kind of wanted to back out, but I did the run. Went to the gym with George, and then I got my ass to work. There was a staff appreciation day happening, so I also got ice cream on this day, so that was a W.
Hello, everybody. I'm done work. I'm meeting Maya. Nothing went wrong at work. It was just kind of overwhelming, and I'm amped up in an anxiety type of way. And I don't know if you can hear me because I didn't bring my stupid mic, so might have to cut all of this audio. I'm gonna get a table at Taco Fino.
Maybe I had a stressful day, but nothing a marg and good friends can't fix. I had a jalapeno margarita, we got some nachos, Elsie met up with us, and we came home to make our homemade tacos, actually. It was super fun and very, very tasty. It's always just great to be able to spend time with friends and make your own dinner.
Hello, folks. Obviously a car aside, but we made it home from the dinner party. Biked home. That was super fun. Love a summer bike. And now I'm about to go to bed. I have my alarm set for 5 a.m. as per usual. I don't think I'm gonna run tomorrow though. I think I'm gonna do a cycle. I'm just gonna do laps of Stanley Park until kind of hits maybe like 1.5 hours in. I'll just like, you know what? I'll just do an hour, not an hour and a half. I'm gonna do laps of the park for about an hour, come back. Cool. I think I'll get about 20 kilometers in.
I thought this ride was gonna feel really good, but it didn't. My legs felt super weak, but the view was really beautiful, so I can't really complain too much. And then I got my ass to work. Honestly, the day passed by pretty uneventfully. I went on a walk during my lunch break, so that was probably the highlight, and then I just went home. Afterwards, I went to my grandparents for supper. That was really yummy. It's super nice to be able to spend time with them. And then it was the next day, and I was out on another run.
Hello. I knew I wanted to get out on a run today. My body's just tired, so it's not going that great. I'm only gonna do 5, call it a day.
I wasn't feeling it this week. My legs were weak. I only did 5 kilometers. I got to the gym, came home, did some work. I had some meetings, and then I was doing some prep for the party. There's a whole video about it if you're interested.
It's professional.
Roy came and visited me also during his lunch break, so that was fun. But eventually, I had to finish up my day of work. I got everything I needed to done, and then I met up with Roy. We had a quick snack together before I had to get to my eyelash appointment. It was out in Brentwood, so he joined me, and we saw a little corgi, and then I got my eyelashes done. This was the result. I was so happy. Came to Turner's, and then we watched Jury Duty. The next day, I did a bunch of work. Then we went to Costco to get some supplies for my birthday party. We were trying to get in and out as quickly as possible, and then I went home, finished my day of work, and then I got a manicure. Friday was a really nice evening. I just met up with Nicole. We went on a nice little walk together. We went to General Public, had some sushi, a mojito. What more can a girl ask for?
Oh my God, hi, I'm home. I'm so tired. I walked like almost 14 kilometers after leaving work, so definitely my body's like ready to go to bed. And I have to get up early tomorrow because I'm going to White Pine with Ruth and Kiara. Early in the morning, we're gonna go paddleboarding like we did last year. So it's all gonna be fun. It's supposed to be hotter than it was last year too, which is nice. As soon as I gave my little monologue right there, I literally almost forgot to upload this Nobody Asked episode. The one that I was like, oh my fucking God, like if I hadn't uploaded this, I would have lost my little like 6 month streak of doing a good job uploading videos twice a month to this series. On one hand, it's been really, really nice having to make videos like this because like I'm getting stuff out, but on the other hand, it can be kind of annoying. So if I were to like do a challenge like this again, I think I would force myself to only do one video per month. But it is kind of cool that in theory, if I keep this up by December, I could potentially have 24 videos to this series. So not bad.
I got up nice and early on Saturday to get to Ruth's. I always tell myself that like if you're waking up early to not go to work, it's a lot easier. And while that is true, waking up this morning at like 6 a.m. still did not feel amazing, so I am definitely looking forward to sleeping in tomorrow, hopefully sleeping in on Monday. Got to White Pine pretty early and set up shop near the lake, near the rock. Ruth made the most delicious ginger syrup, and then once we were feeling like up to it, we got on the boards, waited for it to be warm enough, of course, and look at me and Ruth with our pit vipers. So cool, not douchey at all. We paddled out on the lake for probably about 45 minutes. That was really fun. It was just a really warm day. I think this was warmer than last year. And then around noon, we decided to pack up. It was getting hot. Overall, the lake was just so beautiful. My favorite. I love Sassamat always. We packed up the paddle boards, and then I got dropped off at Turner's house, and we came and visited my grandparents for a little bit. We all watched Family Law together, and then I came home and took a shower and got ready because we were going to Kai's dad's place, and we picked up some Prosecco because me, Maya, Sam, and Turner, we were making some Aperol spritz together. And look at the spread and also the view. It was just so much fun to get together with everyone. And these are little drinkies.
So small.
This is another one of the views. Like, it's actually insane. I could see the hospital from there. And also, it was almost a full moon, so it was looking real bright. Look at that. So pretty. Afterwards, Maya, Sam, and Turner and I left a little bit early to get a drink on our own and kind of catch up, because Turner had never met Sam before. Also, on the way back, we saw this cute little mouse. Saturday, I got up early to do some grocery shopping, and then I made the cookies. That was nice. We watched some more Jury Duty. And then it was time to do some serious prep for the party. You're testing the confessionals and getting everything put together, doing all the flower decoration. Yeah.
People dream high in the quiet of the night, you know that I caught it.
We're about an hour away from starting the party. I don't actually think anyone's gonna come on time, but should be good. We still have to set up the charcuterie board. Turner's just in the background. How you feeling?
Good.
Yeah?
Yeah, just waiting for the show to start.
Get out of here. It makes me want you more.
Don't take like a full sip. Like literally just...
Can I take a fake sip?
No, you gotta take a real sip.
It smells really good.
Oh. Oh my God, it's so spicy.
You like it?
It's really spicy.
Is it like...
Just grew it up in these trying times when not trying.
You can take... It's like only a little. It's got a bite.
You know, I think that this whole birthday party is just a cover up. You know, there's a baby there. Not everybody's drinking alcohol. You know, someone just has to say it. I think Turner's pregnant.
I love olives and I love saffron and I'm so excited. I don't think it's a surprise.
play?
Yeah.
You ready?
Yes.
Your cookies are great.
I don't have a confession to make. I just am sitting here.
I'll have a confession if Saffron has a confession. Who was your other crush in camp before Turner?
I hate to say it, but there was literally nobody else.
Where?
Like, literally nobody.
Did you have a crush on anyone else at this party that doesn't have to be from camp?
No. I don't have crushes on a lot of people. I'm boring. It's literally only Turner.
Her confession is Turner for life. Turner for
yeah,
life.
My confession is Turner for life. What is your confession?
You have two really cute friends.
I won't tell you who, but you do. That's my confession.
Oh, that is some spicy confession. Okay, okay, we can leave it at that. I love it. We have some serious production quality.
Oh my god!
We're doing a birthday gift unboxing.
This is also a half housewarming gift too, for when you move into your apartment.
God. It's La Petite Bay, my favorite.
It smells so good. I was like,
it smells so delicious.
Of course. I saw it this week and I was like, she has to have it. And then this one I saw in Sephora and I was like,
oh, holy shit!
Wait, no, turn it, turn it. I know. I was like, because I feel like Dry Bar is like another like.
Yeah.
Thing.
Thank you. I was like, when we were in Nashville and you had the big rollers, I was like, she needs some good ones. There's splits too. Of course. I love you. Happy birthday.
Thank you.
So just like,
yeah. Confess something.
Confess something.
What the hell am I confessing here?
Confess something on behalf of Kai Kai. We have one other vegetarian friend that he gives so much shit to, and Kai Kai truly does not like vegetarians. Like, he has deep-rooted agenda against vegetarians, so I wanted you to know that. Happy birthday.
I do know a vegan person that is very much a struggle to be with. When you need to eat.
Another confession.
It's a confession. Just when you need to go out, you have to make them a priority, not you a priority.
Yeah, I don't hate vegetarian people, Saffron.
I don't hate them either. It's just a thing.
Yeah, it's just fun.
Okay, this might be a hot take, but I'm convinced that people only like Saffron because she's a really kind, generous, outgoing, wholesome person. I don't know. I think she might only be popular because she's actually really genuine and sweet. This might be controversial. I don't want to be the first one to start this rumor, but that's just what I think. That's just the harsh reality of it.
Who are you going to go after next?
Gotta get Tay, Matias, and Esther.
All right, let's go.
Hey guys, welcome to the Camp Podcast.
Rory's literally been entertaining all of my guests.
He's the host, the co-host, and other co-hosts of this entire.
Yeah, there's three co-hosts, and it's all Rory.
Well, do you want a party or do you want to?
No, this is his literal dream. He's like entertaining. He's been waiting for this day the whole year so that he could like. It's not my birthday today. It's Rory's party.
Maybe your birthday, but it's my time to shine.
I've just been like humbled every year that people are like willing to come and like.
I'm all ready to go quit
them. Yeah. I know that like on birthdays sometimes I go into it being like, oh, this is very selfish to celebrate my birthday, but then I also like, I think for me it's like a moment of gratitude to be able to be like, oh my god, so many people are like willing to just show up. So yeah, thank you so much. I love every one of you. You are so important to me, so thank you.
Hi everyone.
Wait, are you videoing this?
Well, it feels a bit obnoxious to stand in the middle.
He loves it.
You love it! Come on.
Right there, Rory. Perfect shot. Thank
Hi
you.
Hi there, guys. I know for those of you who were here last year, I give a very long-winded speech, but
Today's not about me.
It is about you.
It's always about you.
So, today, it's really hard to buy a gift for Saffron. Because Saffron doesn't really value anything materialistic, so the costs I put on whatever I buy her really doesn't mean anything to her. As to correspond with her as a person, what she really values is the emotional merit and the effort put in of what she did. In that regard, I didn't really do much, but I did do something that was very aligned with the experiences me and Saffron have experienced, and that is I stole something. Not that Saffron, whatever.
Corny.
But I stole.
Oh my God.
So for those of you who don't know, me and Saffron worked at a camp together for a couple years. And this was an award we gave out at the end of the year that our boss owned. Please don't ask me how I got this. I had a really fun night last night.
Did you break it?
You broke it a little bit.
Anyhow, the point of this award is that it recognizes the achievements of certain people who did great things at camp. And I think it's fair to award this to Saffron as an overall achievement of her merit of character and compassion, wherein each and every week, in camp there are 8 weeks of achievements. I think Saffron shows up every day and every week and makes sure everyone has the best day. So I think I'd be willing to cross out every name on this list and put Saffron's every week, because she's the only one who puts the effort in. Congratulations, Saffron.
So what's the tea at this party this year?
Some of the tea at the party right now. There's someone here that I matched with on Hinge, and I might have ghosted them.
I didn't know you ghosted them.
I did. Other tea, I've noticed that Rory walks differently since he's been back from Edmonton. I don't know why, but he's walking a bit different.
Oh, so I have some tea. Yeah.
Turner is an outfit repeater. He wore the same outfit to Saffron's birthday last year. So even if it's different font, same outfit.
I was thinking about this before. I was like, I know that she's only, but I'm like, Saffron is really the big sister I never had.
She's our mom.
You're our mother. I always say that you're such a calming presence in my life. Like, I literally love our group chat, like girls chat, but I'm like, I feel like we all talk to each other about everything going on in our lives, and I appreciate that so much.
Can we do some ASMR?
I trust you with my life.
Literally.
We trust you both with our lives.
Our lives.
And we quite literally did.
We quite literally did like several times.
We're here to like live this day, and that's all we can
see. Yes. I don't know where I'd be without you. I trust her advice more like anything. You are wise beyond your years, and I love that about you. I just want to say a quick hello.
She's our older sister. She's a constant in all of our lives. She's always the...
Rory's
interrupting my speech.
Rory's
interrupting
my
very good things right now.
I love you for Nashville. You put up with me and Meredith's bullshit.
Guys,
and we owe you for life.
That will never be, like, that will be a trip to never forget. You know how men are like 6 years old and they always talk about this one trip to Vegas? That is our Nashville trip.
That is our Nashville trip.
Solo moment. I'm saying a huge shout out to my friends on the other side of the camera, and a huge shout out to Saffron. Happy freaking birthday. She's our mom, she's our queen, she's our mother. I'm shooting my solo.
Hello.
This is gonna be a lot of footage.
We're in this girls' cabin signing out. All of us are here together. I'm so happy that we're all here together. When does this happen? Well, happy birthday. Quarter life, we're obsessed with you. You're a big sister. Mwah! Slay!
Monday morning, we were doing some cleanup, and eventually once that was done, me, Ben, and Turner went out for breakfast at Jimmy's Lunchbox, and then we drove Ben to the ferry. I came home and I went on a ride with my dad. We just went out to UBC and back.
Hello, dinner is done. I edited for a little bit. The footage from last night is so funny. There's a lot to go through though. Those confessionals are so funny. Rory, I know if you're like watching this because it doesn't have a scene of you in it. You didn't use the mic the entire night. None of your confessionals are usable. I can't with you.
I bust out to Commercial Drive to meet everyone. It was just a nice little hangout and I just love seeing these people.
Hello, I am on my way to gym with George. I actually decided to sleep in a little bit. I didn't do any cardio. My hip has been bothering me, so giving it a rest. Also, it's been a long weekend, so.
George and I did a chest day together, got our coffee, I came to work, had a seminar, and then just did work.
Hello, home from work, and I'm just chilling. I'm meeting Silk for dinner tonight. It's gonna be really fun. We're eating in the West End, so that's very nice for me. I'm just gonna walk there. Today was a good day at work. I stayed a bit later than I usually do, so I only have like 20 minutes at home to rest before having to go out again.
Apparently during dinner, I forgot I was a vlogger, so I only took pictures, but here was the dinner we had. It was very yummy. Oh, and I remembered to vlog again, and then we went to get some dessert. We got bubble tea from two different places. I got a really, really yummy coconut one. It was very nice. Ended the night by editing.
Hi. Ew. I'm about to head up to the gym. I'm 25. It's very exciting. Just gonna do a quick Stairmaster session and then come home, shower, and then go to the gym with George.
Like I said, I was heading to the gym to do the Stairmaster. Ended up doing around 40 minutes. It was very fun. Got home, showered, did my hair. I was feeling very cute. Got to the gym with George. We did a leg day, put on my power suit. I was so happy. I had such a good day at the office. My team took me out for lunch. It was so thoughtful, and I even had a birthday cake. I just had a really good day at work.
Hello everybody, I had a fabulous day at work. So my coworker Mocha bought me and Alex, another coworker whose birthday was last week, he bought us like a tiramisu cake, as you saw. It was so delicious and I got to take a piece home, so I'm taking it over to my grandparents. Yeah, it just went really well. It was a really interesting day and I got to present some work with another colleague of mine about trauma-informed analysis work. Like, it was just a very good day. I'm just feeling the birthday love. I'm happy. So far, being 25 is fabulous. I love it.
Saw the cutest dog on the way to my grandparents' place, and I got there. Me and my grandfather shared a cider together. I got to taste some of my grandmother's food before heading off to meet up with Ruth and Brayden. We went to La Mezcaleria, and it was super tasty. I had a lot of margaritas. There was a margarita I got by accident, and then a margarita flight. It was really tasty, and I got two tacos. It was just very fun. I also just loved the drive, and I ended up seeing one of my coworkers who passed by, and then of course we went and got ice cream afterwards.
Okay, we're getting some ice cream. What flavor are you getting, Brayden?
Choco, milk choco, I don't know.
What are you getting?
The blueberry honey lavender.
What are you getting?
Cookies and cream.
And Hong Kong milk tea.
And Hong Kong milk tea.
I ended up getting Earl Grey and blueberry lavender. It was so delicious. And then Turner drove us home where I could go edit the vlog. Everyone, not only have we reached the end of the vlog, but we've also reached the end of another year. I'm officially 25 today. Sometimes when I put it in numbers, the fact that I started this vlog when I was 21 and now I'm 25 is actually unbelievable, especially looking back on 24. I have to say, this was like such a good year. It's probably one of the best years recorded on the vlog. Like, I got to travel so much. There was less of a impact from the pandemic. I didn't have like several super major crisis events in one year, which is great. I love that. I just feel a lot of gratitude for the people in my life. I think this year I was really surrounded by really amazing people who supported me and loved me, and it really means a lot. I don't know, I was just thinking about the party on Sunday, and it really, every year it's just so amazing that people will show up for me and celebrate me. It's really special and I'm like so grateful for it. 25 is a weird year because I feel like on a physiological level
your brain is fully developed. And then I guess in terms of what the number looks like, 25 feels somehow old and young at the same time. I'm excited for this year. I think I'm just intrigued to see the amount of growth I'm gonna do, and I'm excited to continue to have new memories with friends and grow up more. Every year I'm able to be a bit more confident in myself and a bit more sure and able to set boundaries, say no, and just be a bit of a better person. So I'm just really excited to see what I have in store for myself and to just see the person that I grow into in this next chapter of my life. Of course, thank you for watching. I know a lot of you have been watching since the beginning, so thank you for watching like 3 years of my life. And as we go into this new year, I hope that you'll stick with me and continue joining me on this project, I guess. Yeah, so thank you for watching, and I'll see you next week.
I don't want to fight you, and I don't want to sleep. Welcome to the vlog.
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 Welcome to the vlog. Season 4.
Welcome to the vlog.